Buonasera, here we are. Today we're going to do something special, something that, again, you want to know how to do it. Yes, it's the typical, the classic, the everyone knows about the carbonara, spaghetti carbonara. It's very simple, but you need to know the steps how to do it. And today I tell you the way I do it, and I think it's the easiest and the best way to do carbonara. First thing first, water boiling. Pasta, good quality pasta. Good Parmesan cheese. Nice lion eggs. What is lion eggs? Lion eggs is they have been checked, they have been tested that they are good quality. And the main thing is the guanciale. Guanciale is a pork chicks, cured pork chicks, which is the best. It's nice and sweet. When you take it off the fat, you will see the taste of this nice crispy bacon. Okay, we have the boiling water. Have to be boiling. Don't put any oil in there because you don't want the pasta to stick. Make sure the bubbles will do the job. So first thing is put in the salt. Not too much salt, but enough salt that will salt the pasta. Then you open up the bag. Of course, you cannot put with the bag oven, of course not. And use 100 grams, 120 for each person. So put the pasta in there, put a little bit more. And what you do, you think, is outside the water, what is gonna happen? It's not gonna be cooking. Yes, just push it and it will go in because the other part becomes soft. And look, it's all in and you don't need to worry about it. Now it does all the job. If it's not boiling, the thing that you have to do is cover it up and it will boil it. So now I've got basically 7 minutes to do the sauce. It's simple and I'll share with you. So this is the guanciale, cured guanciale. Ask you Italian delicatessen and they will get you the best guanciale. So slice it, nice thin slice. It's beautiful, it's very, very nice. There is not much meat in there, but the fat is what you need for this dish here. Look, it's very nice. Here is boiling. So let's take it off and we put the other one on. Mix the pasta again, so you make sure that it's all in inside the water. And he is doing his job. This is on. And for one portion, you need just 4 little slices put together and very thin strips of guanciale. Is what you need. Yeah, look, that's look nice and thin slices. So I'm gonna swap the frying pan with this, and I don't need to put any oil in this. The fat it will do it. So while this is frying, I will prepare my sauce. The sauce, there is no cream, there is nothing. It's just Parmesan cheese, yep, and one egg. You put one egg, but egg yolk. Don't use the white, because otherwise you make an omelette, and you don't want an omelette, you want a carbonara. Put one egg yolk in there, and wait that the bacon is nice and crispy before you can do the rest. Now, while this is cooking, I need some hot water to be able to make this dish. gonna put in there. You see? Melting all together. And you will see that this is gonna be nice and creamy pasta. And for you to have it. Another ingredient that is very, very important for this dish, don't miss it because it's very, very important, is black pepper. Fresh ground black pepper. Always keep an eye on the other stove. Nice, quite a lot. It gives a nice flavor. Nice taste is one of the ingredients actually on this dish. You see, it's all nice and liquid. The cheese melted in there and is ready to be done. The bacon is nice and crispy. Look at that, it's beautiful. The smell, how good is it, just like that. So when it's ready, so we got everything worked out in the right way. Timing is important. You have to judge what to do first and what is going on. That's the heart of being a chef. I'm not expecting you that. You can prepare this before. I don't want you to do in 7 minutes. Do one by one. You can do this first. You can do that first. When you got this ready and that ready, then put the whole thing together. The pasta, it will take another 2 minutes, I guess. It's bubbling away. Nice. Make sure that the pasta is al dente and not raw. How do you see the difference if the pasta is al dente or raw? When you cut in the middle and you see this white line, it means it's raw. So don't give it the time that it needs to give, and have a glass of wine in the meantime, don't worry. It's time is what you need to give to the pasta. Okay. While the pasta, you see all the liquid that all the fat that is now in the sauce here. And what I'm gonna do, now I'm gonna put the pasta into the bacon, not the bacon to the pasta. There we are. So all the pasta is absorbing this nice flavor of the bacon, so it becomes all one thing. A little bit of water, pasta water, with cheese all the touches there. And what I'm gonna do now is put the pasta into the bowl. Mixing all together. Of course, the pasta that is 100 degrees, it will make the egg to 63 degrees at least. And I need to release the starch from the pasta to the sauce. Don't overcook it, just give it the right temperature. If you boil it, if you put on the fire straight away, it does go to our omelette. Look, nice and creamy. So what I need to add now is a little bit of Parmesan cheese here, and that's it, it's just mixing to release the starch. Look at that, that's nice. The fire is off, so everything is off. And now we're gonna plate up. I don't need this anymore. Under there. And now I'm gonna put my pasta on the plate. Here we are. Look at that. Nice portion of carbonara. Oh, the creamy, but there is no cream. I call creamy, but okay, a bit of fresh Parmesan cheese. Look at that. Oh, that's nice. A sprinkle of black pepper. And ladies and gentlemen, here is your carbonara. Look at that, beautiful, ready to eat, nice and smoky, and the flavor is unbelievable. Enjoy it, enjoy with your family, enjoy with your friends. Ciao, alla prossima.